But actually, going back to your speciality, so what is conversation analysis, and how did you end up specializing in that area, and why is it so important?
So conversation analysis is the study of real talk collected. The data is recordings, so sometimes single cases, sometimes tens, hundreds, or even thousands of recordings of real interactions. So not simulations, not role plays. We don't interview people about their interactions. We don't ask them on a survey. We look at real talk in the wild as it happens. We transcribe in lots of fine grained detail, and then the aim is to kind of understand the complete encounter from the moment it starts all the way through to the end. And over 50 years of research, conversation analysts have shown that we are pushed and pulled around by language. By that, I don't just mean words. I mean everything that we use as a resource to interact with others. So, of course, our gestures, our gaze, our intonation, all of those things that we are bringing to bear to do things in interaction. So we look at all of those things and how people are pushed and pulled around by them, by what happens at the opening of the encounter, how does that sort of manifest in a trajectory all the way through to the end. And conversation analysts are working, it's a discipline that started in sociology, but now it's rather interdisciplinary, linguistics, communication, psychology, in many of the world's languages there are people working, and there's together there's a sort of cumulative 50-year body of research to show how communication, human communication, works. And the reason that I think it's really important to do this kind of work and also talk about it outside of academia is because communication is one of those really difficult topics in a way. Everyone's interested and everyone thinks they know a lot about it because everyone's been talking their whole lives and has all of their anecdata to go on. And when you say, how did that conversation go and what did you say and all those things, but actually it's this mysterious thing happens when you ask people about how human communication works. Somehow the actuality of real interaction seems to just slide away into the ether, and people will tell you things that they have got from the media, pop psychology, their memories, just things that sound right about how people talk to each other. And what that means is that there's lots of myths, lots of very, very solid sounding, very sensible sounding facts about communication that just aren't when you actually study communication, properly. On the one hand, you want to sort of bust myths. And on the other hand, you want to be able to show things that might be quite egregious problems and things that are happening. So to give you an example, it's probably quite important to know what happens inside, let's say something like a police interview with a suspect. How are you going to find out what happens in a police interview with a suspect? You could interview a police officer and you could interview a suspect. Or you could look at the actual interaction. And then you could look at, okay, does this interview seem to align with what we assume is going on by the letter of the law? And, in almost any setting you can think of, there's the things that we imagine are happening, and then there's what's actually happening. And sometimes what's actually happening is much better than what you might imagine from, how this conversation is meant to run off. And sometimes there are real problems. So someone once described conversational analysis to me, and they thought they were being kind of critical. They thought this was a winning takedown. Oh, isn't it just a method in search of a problem? And I think that's a great description, actually, of at least a lot of the work that I do. I'm trying to show how interaction actually works, and also sometimes the damage people are doing in conversations that just get never seen, never exposed, because no one's really looking at recordings of actual conversations.